Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.4.1 to the public. This is available to all iOS 14 supported devices, so if you have an iPhone 6S or newer, it will be available to that, as well as iPad Air 2 and newer as well. Now this came in at 138.3 megabytes, that's on my iPhone 12 Pro. It can vary in size depending on the device you're using, but in general, if you're coming from iOS 14.4, for example, it will be about that size. Now if you're not seeing the update, you can install this by going to your Settings app, then going down to General, tapping on Software Update, and it should be available. If you're still not seeing it, tap on Automatic Updates, turn off Download iOS Updates, and then check again, and it should show up. Now let's go ahead and talk about the build number and then take a look at what's new. Now like I said before, I have iOS 14.4.1 on my iPhone 12 Pro, as well as the iPhone 8 Plus, iPhone SE, the second generation, and Apple also released iPadOS 14.4.1 along with watchOS 7.3.2 and macOS 11.2.3. I have iOS 14.5 Beta 3 on my iPhone 12 Pro Max right here, and if you're on the beta, you will not see this update. So just keep that in mind. You won't see it. You would need a computer to install this update if you're on one of the betas, such as iOS 14.5 Beta 1, 2, or 3. Now let's take a look at the build number. We'll go to Settings, then General, then About, and you can see the build number is 18D61. So this is not a huge update, but there are some changes in it. Now in this update, there is no modem update. So if you're using an iPhone 12 Pro, for example, you won't have a modem update. And as far as new features are concerned, well, there is not anything specified whatsoever other than a couple things I'll mention in a moment with security. But as far as features, Apple did release a couple other things today to go along with this, for example. So if we go into the App Store, and we go to today, for example, you'll see that it's Women's History Month. So to celebrate that, as well as International Women's Day today, Apple released a bunch of different suggestions as far as apps that have been developed by women, and you'll see 9 awesome women-led apps, for example. So you have a bunch here and some more information about that throughout the month. Also to go along with that is in the podcast app. So for example, the first time you open the podcast app, you may see that pop up, but you'll see it says the power of sisterhood. So there's some more suggestions within the podcast app for that as well. Now also Apple released the Kids Listening Club, for example, or a kids and family section within podcasts. And this includes things like Common Sense Media Picks, One More, Kids Know Best, and Storytime. So if we go into here, you'll see there's One More, Kids Know Best, doesn't want to stay in the center there, and Storytime. So you have all of these things under Kids and Family. So if you want to listen to some podcasts, you'll have those as an option, for example. So that's for Kids and Family, and they've been curated for the podcast app. So that's new, although that's available to all iOS 14 versions, it seems. Now, within this update, there is no mention of a fix for green tint. In fact, that's part of iOS 14.5, which they're continuing to work on, as well as some other issues. But Bluetooth does so far seem to be a little bit better for me. A lot of people with iOS 14.4 were having issues with Bluetooth, for example, with disconnects. So far, it seems to be behaving a little bit better, and it seems to just be fixed. So whatever they did, hopefully they updated that, but they didn't specify it anywhere, but hopefully it's a little bit better. Now, as far as features, there's nothing really major in this update that will be left for iOS 14.5, but Apple is pushing this because of security concerns. And specifically, one major issue that they mention, now they only mention one, that doesn't mean there isn't more than one, but the one that they mention is pretty major and has to do with WebKit specifically, which is what runs the internet basically for Safari. It's the underlying code, for example. And the impact was said to be processing maliciously crafted web content may lead to arbitrary code execution. In order to fix this, a memory corruption issue was addressed with improved validation. So that has been patched and hopefully makes this much more secure. That was the same patch pushed out to the iPad as well. So it's a pretty major bug that has been patched that was found and is now taken care of. Now, as far as battery life is going to take a couple days to measure. But when I looked at iOS 14.4 and the follow-up I had done before, that particular version, 70% or so of people said that it was better than the previous version or the same. Now, this update hopefully improves some issues. Maybe there was a memory issue that this was patching. But if we look at the settings here in battery health will not degrade based on these updates. I know a lot of people are concerned about that. Battery health is just simply checking your capacity of the physical battery within the phone. So don't worry about that. It may go down, but that's only because the physical capacity went down, not because the update caused it. However, over the last 10 days or so, this phone was not my main phone, but you can expect the same battery life as 14.4 or better, but it will take a few days to know that for sure. Now, as far as performance overall on this update, well, so far it's been nice and smooth. One nice thing is I haven't seen a single bit of lag when closing an app. Now, this seemed to happen with iOS 14.4 and other apps and things running in the background. You'd go and close them and they would just lag or stutter. So far, I haven't seen this on any of my devices, and it did take a couple days to show up in 14.4, but hopefully it doesn't with this one. So far, it's nice and smooth. And also, when you're playing games and everything, you shouldn't see any performance degradation at all. So if we go into Minecraft, for example, you'll see it'll load here. It may take a moment to resume. We'll give it just a second, and you'll see that frame rates are nice and fast and smooth. So no issues here whatsoever. It's nice and smooth, and there is a little bit of lag right there. And now it seems back to normal. So just give it a little bit if it's loading a new world, for example. There we go. And if you're playing Minecraft, Among Us, or Call of Duty Mobile, or any of those, expect it to perform about the same, since this is just basically a security update. And then when it comes to iPadOS 14.4.1, again, it only is specifically addressing that issue that I mentioned with security. And upon initial reboot of this device, it was very slow, but now it's performing just fine. So if I go into security, you'll see that it's a little bit choppy here, but this is an iPad Air 2. So this is an older iPad, one of the older supported devices, and it seems to be performing okay as far as what I'm doing here. So you can do whatever you did before. It's really not going to be a major update compared to iOS 14.4, but it should fix some bugs. Now, as far as Geekbench scores or benchmarks, let's take a look at those. So we'll go into Geekbench 5. And on the iPhone 12 Pro, it scored 1,595 for single core, 3,990 for multi-core. This is pretty good. I ran this right after installing it, so it could actually increase a little bit over the next couple of days. And let's go ahead and take a look at it on all of these devices. Now on the left, we have the iPad Air 2, followed by the iPhone SE second generation, then the iPhone 8 Plus, and then the iPhone 12 Pro. This should just give you a general idea of what to expect if you run the same sort of benchmarks. So these can vary quite a bit based on if you run it right after you install it or not. So you may see better scores than I have. Now, should you install iOS 14.4.1? Well, if you're already on iOS 14.4, I would say absolutely, just for the security patch and hopefully the fix to the lag of closing apps and things like that. It's definitely worth updating to, and I think you'll probably see a little bit better performance and smoothness overall. Now, as far as iOS 14.5 Beta 4, well, iOS 14.5 Beta 3 came out about a week or so ago, so I would expect that as soon as tomorrow. I would think we'll see it tomorrow or Wednesday at the latest, with a final release later in the month. Apparently, there's going to be a March event or some sort of product release on the 23rd of March, and based off that, we'll probably have a final release somewhere around the 23rd or 24th as far as iOS 14.5, which brings a lot of new features and fixes and things like that, such as green tint, for example. So look for that. Hopefully, we'll see that very soon. So that's it for iOS 14.4.1. We'll have to wait a few days to see how battery really is and stability. And of course, I'll have a follow-up about that usually on the weekend around Sunday. So be sure to check back for the community poll and more about that. Now, that's really it for this particular update. Fairly small, but iOS 14.5 is what I'm looking most forward to, since it has a lot of features in it that should add a lot of functionality and some really helpful things with the Apple Watch as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.